Good afternoon, our learners and viewers. This is Chair Robert with another session. In primary three, I'm going to teach mathematics, but I just want to go and use the idea of the multiplication we took at in the previous lessons about multiplication. So without taking a lot of time, I want us to first refer what we are going to look at in this session. We are going to use multiplication to complete given tables. In this class of primary three, at times, they don't tell us to just multiply numbers. They actually get to the tables, they set the tables where we need to use the idea of multiplication of numbers to complete the tables. So in this lesson, I want us to use the multiplication to complete some given tables. But I want us to first of all remember or revise what we looked at in the previous session. In the previous session, I talked about the groups and the number of items. When we talk about multiplication, there are two things that we must understand. We must understand what we are calling the groups and the number of items. We can actually revisit this one here. They can say multiply. This one is helping us remember what we looked at in the previous lesson. Multiply 3 by 2, okay? But remember, we say when we talk about multiplication or multiplying numbers, it is the same as getting the product of numbers. These are two numbers. They are saying 3 multiplied by 2. What does this one mean? I said in the previous lesson, and I want to continue saying, that the first number tells us the number of groups. Then the second number counts the items per group. So for this case, we say this one means we are having the three groups. Let me use these circles, the three of them. These are three groups, okay? But in each group, I must put it two items. Let me use the sticks. I'm putting the first two sticks in the first group, then the second group of the two in the second group, then I'm also putting two sticks in the third group. So together, when I count the total number of sticks in the three groups, the answer I get is 6. Okay, this is what we looked at in the previous session, right? So we are going to use this same idea of the number of groups and the number of items to complete some given tables. So we are just completing the tables using this idea of the groups and the number of items. We can look at some examples here. Let me have this example. Example is here. The first question says, complete the table below. Complete the table below. Okay? The table is here, having two rows, just like this. This is the table we have complete. It has different columns. In the first row, we are having the number of girls, then in the second one, we are having the number of your fingers. Okay? So when you look at this table, in the first row they are saying number of girls. If the girl is one, they are saying one girl has 10 fingers. Okay? When you go to the second part of the row, when the girls are two, they have told us to find the missing number for the number of fingers. When the girls are three, they have told us to find the number of fingers down. When the girls are four, they have told us that the total number of fingers here are 40. Okay? But the question is telling us to complete the table. How are we using the multiplication to complete this table? So this is what we are supposed to do. They are talking about the number of girls and the number of fingers. At the first part, at the beginning, they are saying one girl has 10 fingers, down, okay? Meaning, when the number of girls increase, the number of fingers shall also increase. So how do I use the multiplication to get the missing number for the two, the number of fingers for the two girls? So to get the missing number here, when the girls are two, how many fingers are there? So I'm simply going to come down the table and I say, two girls, they have said one girl has 10 fingers. So for two girls, I will simply say two girls multiplied by 10 to get the number of fingers. So the answer I get here shall become 20. Okay? So I will put the 20 under the two girls. Meaning for two girls, they have 10 fingers, right? Then we shall go to the next step. They are talking about three girls. When the girls are three, what should be the number of their fingers? Remember, when they were starting the table, they guided us and said, when the girl is one, she has 10 fingers. Now, when they are three, using the idea of multiplication, what should I do to know the number of fingers that three girls have? So I will come and I say three girls multiplied by the fingers for just one girl. So one girl has 10 and these ones are three. So using multiplication, I will simply say multiplied by 10 because one girl has 10 fingers, yet these ones are three girls. So when I multiply 3 by 10, I will get this one as 30, right? So for three girls, they have 30 fingers. So the working is very important, or the side work, okay? So by doing that one, I would have completed this table using the idea of multiplication. Don't forget that after the working, when you get your answers, you put them in the spaces that are missing in the table. That is what we are calling completing the tables, okay? I can also give another one. We can also have another example here. Example two. They can at times use the circle. The question is saying complete the circle below. They have drawn up a circle, which is this one here. They have put a small circle, a medium-sized circle, like this. They have said 7 multiplied by, we are using multiplication, they have divided the circle just like this. They put this one here, 3. Then there is some space being made to be looked for. Then there is a 2 here, some space as a number missing. They also give this one here. There is a 5 here, a number is missing. There is 8 here, a number is missing. Let's use probably 4. There is some number missing here. Okay? So in the second example, instead of using the table, they have told us to complete the circle. So in the circle, inside it, there is a smaller circle which has 7 times different numbers, okay? Then in the second circle, in the middle, there are some numbers that we shall multiply by 7. Then the answer we shall get shall be put in the last or in the third circle, the spaces that are provided in the third circle. So this one, the one in the middle, tells us to multiply 7 by any of the numbers in the second circle, okay? So I will choose to say 7 multiplied by 2. What should I do? We are using the year of multiplication. So on my side work, I will say 7 multiplied by 2. What am I supposed to get? Remember the idea of our groups. These are 7 groups of 2. What is the answer? When I multiply 7 by 2, what do I get? I can even draw these ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? What am I supposed to do? I'm putting 2 items. Use sticks. 2 sticks per group. There are 7 groups of 2. 7 groups of 2. When you count the total number of sticks in the 7 groups, the answer I get is 14. So when I multiply 7 by 2, I get 14. What do I do? I write 14 in the space seen in the third part of the circle, where you've multiplied 7 by 2. Okay, I can go to another one. I can choose another one. I say 7 multiplied by 3. What does this one mean? They are 7 groups of 3. When you multiply 7 by 3, let me just go straight. The answer we get is 21. Don't forget, when you get the answer from the side work, you take it to the table of the circle. So we shall write 21 here. Okay? Then I'll take another one and I say 7 multiplied by 5. Okay? These are 7 groups of 5. What do I get? Let me just go straight. The answer I get is 35. So I'll put my 35 there. Okay? Then the last one here, it is 7 multiplied by 4. These are 7 groups of 4. Let me just go straight. The answer is 28. Completing the table or the circle, you put this answer in the space. So by doing this one, after the side work, we put our answers in either the circle or the table as per the question. By doing that, we shall have used the idea of multiplication to complete the circles and the tables as given. Otherwise, because of time, I want to stop with this one, but at the end of it all, we shall have some work that shall be answered during your time. Thank you for being part of this lesson. Catch you up next time. Our dear learners, these are some of the numbers that you're going to answer just after watching this lesson. Thank you so much for attention. I think you've been positioned to enjoy the lesson. I remain Teacher Robert.